you all my current favorite high-end beauty products. And I wanted to start this video by saying I'm due in 2 more days. I wanted to film this video for you guys before I go and deliver my baby, because I don't know how my recovery is gonna be and how long it's gonna take. So I wanted to film this for you all. And that's why I'm starting it off with skincare, and then we're gonna move on to beauty products. I wanted to do this video. I know that these are higher end, hefty price items, but I do feel that they are worth the money and that I've tried them, tested them, and I absolutely love them. So I wanted to share that with you guys. And what's great about high-end products is that when you purchase these from most of the stores they're sold at, a lot of times if you're not happy with them, you can go back and return them. Just keep your receipt. If they don't work out for your skin, you know, at least you gave it a try. So I've done a lot of that, and that's why my list isn't very long, because I am oh so picky with beauty products. But these have made the list, and I definitely feel they're worth trying out. So let's go ahead and move on to my first products, which is skincare. And I was on the search for a natural and organic skincare line that wouldn't harm my baby, because I'll be putting these products all over my body and I didn't want to harm the baby in any way. So I came across these products that are called Wish body products, and they're all natural. They're paraben free, sulfate free, all that good stuff. This is the body butter in blue agave, and it says here that it moisturizes with organic shea butter, organic raspberry butter, organic aloe. It firms with organic seaweed extract, and it purifies with organic rice bran oil. And I absolutely love this. A little bit goes a long way. I've been using it for 1.5 months and I've barely gone through it. I use it in conjunction with the rest of the products from this line, well, at least a few of them, because I like the scents to all be the same, especially if I'm gonna be using them all over my body. I don't wanna use one scent for shaving and then one scent for my cream and then one scent for my body wash. That would be crazy. So I got all blue agave, and it is exclusive to Ulta and Ulta.com. So if you are interested in trying this scent, they only have it at Ulta, and let me tell you, it smells amazing. So the following product is the bath and body gel that they carry. And here it says it moisturizes, it cleanses, and it soothes with organic cucumber. That's what sold me. Cucumber is like my favorite scent ever. I just shook it a little, but I've gone only through very little. A couple of pumps go such a long way, and I really love it. And then I also tried their CC body cream, which is a, like a bronzing, illuminating cream that also corrects, moisturizes, and soothes. And I can honestly tell you, this will give you the J-Lo glow on your legs and body for the summer. It's amazing. And this scent is coconut milk. I wanted something a little bit softer, and the coconut milk smells so delicious. I love it. Now, lastly, my favorite product from this line, and the one that I feel is something that I'll use from now on, is their shave cream in blue agave as well. It moisturizes, it soothes, and it nourishes, and let me tell you all, it is amazing. It left my skin feeling like silk, and I couldn't believe it when I was done, because when I pumped it, it wasn't like a lather. It wasn't like foamy like other products. And not to mention, it does not contain, I know this is gonna sound crazy, propane. I didn't know that some of these products on the shelves have propane. Who would put that on any product? So now that I was pregnant, thank God I got pregnant, because now I look at the labels. But this one is just amazing. It goes on almost like a moisturizer times 10, because when you get out of the shower, you're like, whoa, this feels really good. So I've only used it a few times because I haven't had to shave as often, and it leaves my skin feeling so smooth and silky. This is worth every penny. And it basically contains organic shea butter, soothes with organic green tea, organic coconut oil, jojoba seed oil for nourishing the body and the skin, and of course it's paraben free and sulfate free. I absolutely love the scent. You guys have to go and smell this. It smells so, so good. So this is my favorite out of all of them. If you had to try one, the shave cream is amazing. So that is it for skincare, you guys. I love those products. And then moving on to beauty, we're going to start off with the Chanel LeBlanc Illuminating Base. I absolutely love this base. It's basically like a foundation primer. I said to myself, is this really worth it, Jen? Is it worth buying another one? I tried my foundation without anything on it, with a different primer, and then with this one, and it's such a big difference. I absolutely love this product. So it basically goes on white, and I don't want to waste any of it, literally a white, but then it just fades away and it creates a perfect base for your foundation to be applied. The next product is also from Chanel, and this is called the Soleil Tan de Chanel. It's an illuminating fluid, and it basically creates a really, really nice shimmery glow that I apply everywhere I want to highlight. And if I want more of a highlight, I'll apply this and then I'll go over it with a powder form highlight. But this alone provides such a beautiful finish to the face. You can mix it with your foundation, or you can apply it by itself like I do, just because I want to be able to control the shine. I prefer like a matte finish and then put the shine where I want it to be, especially because I get really oily on the T-zone area. But you can use it either way. It's absolutely amazing. I love this product. And now this product that I'm gonna show you guys, I know it's not like a really expensive product, but I do still consider it high-end because it's a lot more than a drugstore product. But this is my MAC Studio Fix Fluid Foundation, which is one of my favorite ones. I use this one every day because I just love the way it leaves my skin looking. It doesn't look cakey, even though I do apply two coats to build to that full coverage. I do normally use NC15, but it's been a little too light for me now that the sun's coming out in Las Vegas. I've been getting somewhat of a tan around my neck, so I had to go back and get the NC20, and it's worked out great. I really, really love that foundation. And last but not least, the Inglot pigments. I was gonna say eyeshadows, the Inglot pigments. Oh my gosh, I love these things. And the one I have on my eyes right now is number 85. Let's see. There it is right there. It almost has like a greenish, purplish, brownish undertone. It's just so beautiful. And I don't use these dry because I don't feel they're as intense or as beautiful. I mix them with my MAC Fix fluid, and I absolutely love them. Another color that I really love is number 86, which has like a pinkish, reddish, goldish tone to it. See that? It's so beautiful in the eyes, you guys. It almost looks gold, and if you like stand in the sun and turn, and oh, it's just beautiful. And then lastly, their glitters. This one is in 73, which is like a silver tone. I don't know if you can really see that, but they kind of remind me of the Makeup Forever glitters without them being as expensive, and they are so beautiful. I can't even begin to put it into words. I love glitter. That won't change. My next favorite products are brushes. Now, these are pricey brushes, but I feel they are so worth it. And honestly, I don't use them every day because I love them so much. These are the Jenny Padenkin brushes. She's a makeup artist, and she created this line of brushes that is just beyond beautiful. As you can see, I'm putting them, I have them right now in their little case that they come with. You basically just put them in there, and you can travel with these brushes very, very easily, and then they just hook on the sides. But I usually just keep it like this on my makeup counter. And the bristles are just the softest bristles that I've ever worked with. It's beyond words. This one here is the powder and bronzer brush, and then my favorite one is all over face because this is great for foundation, which is beautiful. This is like their blush or highlighter kind of brush, and this is so beautiful, you guys. Like, the way it's been cut or the hair that they're using is just beyond words. I absolutely love these brushes. They're cut to perfection. Another one of my favorites is a multi-blender, because although you can use this for the crease, you can also use this for concealer or things like that. Their eyeshadow brushes are really soft and really well cut. Like, they are just perfection. The quality of the brushes, is you could tell, is different. Now, in comparison with my MAC brushes, which I'm sure a lot of you will be like, how does it compare to MAC? It's different because my MAC ones are pricey too, and they have like stiffer bristles, if that makes sense. When you compare them to her brushes, These are a lot softer. They feel like you're getting a massage on your face. It just feels so amazing. I love, love, love these brushes. So I'll provide links for you guys. This one's also a pinpoint liner one, which is really, really, really small. And it's so cute, and you can get in there and do like a really nice smoky eye. Another one of my favorites is the eyeshadow brush because of the way it's cut. It just creates a nice, like, I don't know, waterfall effect how the bristles are cut. It's just beautiful. So they do sell the set all together, or you can buy them individually. I really, really love these brushes. Again, they're from Jenny Patinkin. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. I told you my list wasn't very long because I am very picky, but I hope you guys found this helpful. Please subscribe, thumbs up the video. I will see you guys really soon. Wish me luck on my C-section, and I will see y'all later. Take care. Bye, everyone.